Another conference. So I'm on behalf of him to give you the speech. I'm a PhD student of Professor Lee on my second grade, and I'm honored to be here. The title of my speech is Silicon-based Anode Materials for High-Capacity Lithium-ion Batteries. I'm from the Institute of Semiconductors, Chinese Academy of Sciences. My presentation is structured in the following way with 5 sections. First, I will give you some background. As we all know, the air pollution is very serious nowadays in big cities such as Beijing and Shanghai. According to the statistics, about 30% of the air contaminant from the automobile exhaust gas, and the effective solution is to develop electric automobiles. Lithium-ion battery is the most commonly used energy storage device to power the automobiles. It has many advantages, such as a high energy density, high working voltage, long cycle life, no pollution, and so on. This figure is the demand and the forecast of lithium-ion batteries in 3 important terminal applications of China from 2011 to 2018. The automobile application in the 3 main applications increased faster than the other 2 in recent years, and it occupies the largest portion in the 3 applications from 2016. This is the yield and growth of lithium-ion batteries of China from 2011 to 2018. The increase rate is always larger than 20%, and the yield of lithium-ion batteries of China will attain 100 gigawatts in 2018. In the techniques of lithium-ion batteries, except for the cathode, anode is also a key technique, and high-capacity anode is urgent demand. This is a map of the electrode materials development in lithium-ion batteries. So, why should we choose a silicon-based anode? Because among all the anode materials, silicon has the largest theoretical specific capacity. These formulas reveal the reasons for the high capacity, which is more than 10 times higher than the graphite anode. With the cathode, if we replace the graphite anode with silicon, the maximum energy density improvement of the battery should attain 40%. If we use higher energy density cathode with the same level, with silicon anode. If we replace anode with silicon, the largest energy density improvement will be 10 times larger. That's to say the automobile, if you use this kind of material and this kind of cathode anode and this kind of battery, it will go 10 times further distance. And graphite added with some portion of silicon and anode material has already begun to produce and apply. Except for the high theoretical specific capacity, compared to graphite anode, silicon anode has some other advantages, such as a larger interlocution potential. Its benefits for the safety of the lithium-ion batteries by reducing the side effects. However, silicon-based anode has some issues, like the large volume tensions and low conductivity and the low Coulombic efficiency. Fortunately, we have some corresponding solutions to address these issues, such as introducing buffer metrics, conducting materials, and the prism. Based on these solutions, many works have been done, such as a yolk cell silicon composite, silicon carbon composite anode. This structure consists of silicon particles coated with thin, conformal, and self-supporting carbon shell. And the additional internal volume space can accommodate the volume dimensions. The nano-sized silicon particles have less volume dimensions, especially when the particle size is less than 100 nanometers, the volume dimension will be negligible. But unfortunately, nano-sized silicon particles will agglomerate due to the high surface electrochemical activity, and this will reduce the electrochemical performance. Another work is a patterned silicon thin film electrode with alumina on the surface. And the patterned thin film electrode has space to surpass the volume extension, and the alumina on the surface can inhibit the side reactions and improve the robustness of the silicon. However, it has some problems, such as a low mass of material, low energy density, and complicated process. Also, the preparation process is not compatible with existing battery processes. Another work is a 3D structure with nickel nanocoin array supported silicon anode. With a nickel array structure, it can facilitate the charge collision and the transportation. It can also support the electrostructure and acts as an inactive buffer medium. But this 3D structure also has a thin problem, like the thin film electrode material. Silicon nanowire is considered as a good anode material of silicon. The silver cutlass electrochemical etching method is applied to prepare this material, and the silicon nanowire can inhibit the electrical conductivity of the original silicon, and the volume space between the nanowires can accommodate the volume extensions, and it will do not agglomerate like the nano-sized ones. However, the problems is very difficult to produce in large scale, and the process of the preparation is very expensive. Based on these solutions and the methods, we propose the idea of using paralyzed polystyrene silicon anode. And the experimental procedures is shown as follows. Polycrystalline silicon particles with macro size is used as a starting material, and the metal-assisted chemical etching method is applied. And after that, the nanostructure material is mixed with conductive agents and binder, and finally, the hot cells are assembled and tested. This structure has many advantages, such as polycrystalline silicon is very cheap, and the chemical process is benefit for mass production. The macro-sized silicon particles do not agglomerate like the nano-sized silicon particles, and the polycrystalline acid is acidic to hold the silicon particles used as bender. This scheme and the SEM image shows that the macro-sized nanostructure particles are well obtained. And from the voltage and the specific capacity relationship, we can know that the initial Coulombic efficiency should be 78%. This figure is the Coulombic efficiency of the nanostructure silicon and the crystalline silicon at anode for the lithium-ion batteries. This silicon, after the chemical etching process with nanostructures, have improved Olympic efficiency. So by further optimizing this chemical etching process, we prepared a micro-sized nanopolar silicon with carbon coating. The difference between these two experiments is nanopolar structure is obtained, and PAN is introduced as a carbon source. Except for these two advantages, the macro-sized nanopolar silicon particles has stable structure, and the parallelized PAN can act as conductive network and hold the silicon particles without the additional conductive agents or binder. And the nanopores in the nanostructure can also relieve the volume tensions. This SEM image shows a different size of nanopore silicon particles are well obtained by this method. And the pore size is about 100 nanometers and very uniform. As comparison, the particle before this chemical etching process has very smooth surface. Silicon anode with parallelized PAN is just used as electrode without additional conductive agents and binder. This SEM image is electrode surface of different size of nanopore silicons, and this is just the silicon particle. The electrodes with silicon size of 100 nanometer and 1 micrometer keep integrity after the parallelized process. As comparison, obvious cracks on the surface with large silicon particles. So we suspect that 1 micrometer porous silicon particle, if you use as anode for lithium-ion batteries, should have better electrochemical performance. These two figures is the cyclic performance of the electrodes. From the two figures, you can see the obvious peak and about 1.2 volts, which originate from the lithium-ion interpolation into the parallelized PAN in the first cycle. But fortunately, this peak disappeared from the second cycle, which will not affect or reduce the Coulombic efficiency anymore. The offset peaks and these two peaks correspond to the formation of lithium and silicon alloys. And the reduction peaks originate from the deinterpolation of lithium ions from the alloys to form silicon components. From the cycling performance of these four figures, we can see that the different size of polar silicon, as shown in figures A, B, and C, we can see that the 1 micrometer polar silicon has better electrochemical performance. And this anode maintains a reversible capacity of more than 3000 milliampere hour per gram. And the initial Coulombic efficiency could be 84%. And the reversible capacity more than 2000 milliampere hours per gram after 100 cycles, and the Coulombic efficiency is 99.5%. The silicon anode as a anode material of lithium-ion batteries still not satisfactory because large volume tension. Silicon suboxide anode is an alternative and is considered because the oxide element in the material can react with lithium ions and produce buffer components. So the cycling stability will be better than silicon anode. and this is the experimental procedures. The macro-sized silicon suboxide powder is used as the starting material, and the high-energy foaming process is applied. And also the half cell are assembled and tested. Some other advantages are shown here, as the size-reduced particles have less volume tensions, and the conductive agents with synergistic effect have improved conductivity. And the polyacrylic acid is elastic to hold the silicon suboxide particles as bender, and the lithium silicate phase and the lithium oxide can release the volume tensions during the sectoring. This is a electrochemical performance conducted. From figures A and B, we can see that with the optimized conductive agents, the silicon suboxide electrode after the foaming process has a reversible capacity of 1,400 milliampere-hours per gram, with Coulombic efficiency more than 99.8% after 100 cycles, and the capacity rotation should be 83.6. From the rate performance as shown in figure C, we can conclude that the reversible capacity is always larger of the foamed silicon suboxide electrode compared with the anode before the process. And the relationship between the voltage and the specific capacity shows that the initial Coulombic efficiency is relatively low because the reaction between the oxide element with lithium ions. But the Coulombic efficiency keeps very high from the second cycle. And the second scalability is better than raw silicon, as expected. Many characteristics also conducted to prove this good sectoring performance. This is the SEM image of the particles after and before the foaming process. We can know that after the process, irregularly shaped particles are obtained, and the particle size is reduced to less than 5 micrometers. This is a TEM image of the silicon suboxide electrode after the foaming process, after deinterpolation. And this component with the interplane spacing of 0.4 nanometer and the three circles in the SAED results agree well with the lithium silicate. So this buffer component is successfully obtained. The XRD patterns of the particles after and before the foaming process reveals that after this process, the crystalline structure do not change, and the board peaks ascend to silicon dioxide, and other peaks ascend to silicon monoxide, and these peaks match well with the Bragg peaks shown at the bottom. From the XPS result, as shown in the two figures on the right, we can know that the component of silicon and the oxide elements has a ratio of about 5 to 8. And the silicon 2P spectral in this figure also illustrates that this peak is deconvoluted into 5 positions, which correspond to different volume state. As silicon suboxide has better silicon stability than silicon, but it also has poor conductivity. So we suspect that between further introducing the carbon coating, the cycling performance will be further improved. This experimental procedure is shown as follows. The difference between this is the introduce of the citric acid as a carbon source and anode to form the silicon suboxide with carbon composite material. And this material also has its advantage as particles with all the carbon coating. This high resolution PEM image of different ratios of silicon suboxide with carbon composite material is shown here. It reveals that with the increase of the carbon content, the amorphous carbon layer on the surface is thicker, and the element marking result shown in figure D also confirms the uniform distribution of carbon electrons on the surface. Also, the electrochemical performance are also conducted. From the CV curves, we can know that the peak and about 0.7 is related to the formation of SDR layer, and the initial replaceable capacity can be 1,300 milliampere hours, which can be seen in this figure. And the Coulombic efficiency takes more than 99.8% after even 200 cycles. And from the rate performance, we can know that the composite electrode has higher reversible capacity and all countries than the electrode without the carbon coating. And finally, we can draw that these conclusions. First, as for the macro-size nanocore polycrystalline silicon anode material, this polycrystalline silicon particle is very cheap and mass produced and can be mass produced. And the macro-size silicon framework do not agglomerate as the nano-size ones. And the nanopores of the porous silicon structure can release the volume extensions. As for the second part, the macro size four-milled silicon suboxide with carbon coating anode material. The size reduced particles have released the volume extensions, and the lithium silicate phase and the lithium oxide phase can also act as buffer component to relieve the volume tensions. And the polyacrylic acid is used as a bender, and it is acidic to hold the silicon suboxide particles. And these particles with optimal conductive agents with synergistic effect has improved conductivity and rate performance. Thank you for your time and attention.
Difference between these two materials?
Yeah, silicon and silicon oxide.
Because the silicon suboxide has oxide elements, and it will react with the dissonance in the first cycle, and can result with the lithium silicate and the lithium oxide components. And these two components can accommodate the volume tensions, and so the second stability will be better than CP. second annual.